SES Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana, yes. Yes. For the better part of today, Senior Counsel Ahmed Nasir Abdullahi has been trending. And he has been trending because his tweet on Raila Odinga later turned out to be a flat lie, a propaganda. So in this video right now, I want us to have a look at the tweet, and then we also have a look at the video that he attached with the tweet. After which, as usual, in this YouTube channel, we are going to dissect that and put it squarely where it belongs politically. But before we do that, let's have a look at the tweet. Ahmed Nasir Abdullahi. ODM is filthy rich. Imagine Kenya shillings 1,000 per person for attending yesterday's rally. And then where things go bad is when he attaches that video there. Yes, that video. So Ahmed Nasir is just trying to insinuate that this video was taken yesterday, and it was taken when youths were being bribed to attend Raila's Kamkunji rally yesterday. Yes. But if you look at this video, I know quite a number of you might have watched this video before. Personally, I watched this video about 4 months ago. So Ahmed Nasir here is just attaching this video, alleging that the video was taken yesterday as youths were being bribed yesterday to attend Raila's Kamkunji rally. You know, the rallies largely shocked very, very many people. Specifically, the Tanga Tanga, Ahmed Nasir being part of the group. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a look at the video, after which we are going to dissect it and put it squarely where it belongs politically. Let's have a look at the video. Yes, that's the video. And from that video, ladies and gentlemen, that video is about an aspirant by the name of Andiwo Mwai. Andiwo Mwai is an aspirant for Bondo parliamentary seat next year. And that video, ladies and gentlemen, has been going viral online for some months now. Personally, just as I did in the Capes, I watched the video about 4 months ago. And I know you might have also watched it before. So, what does this show or tell us about Tanga Tanga and this people supporting Tanga Tanga? Because slightly over a week ago now, Millicent Omanga was also exposed. You know, Millicent Omanga's story versus the university student who sells chips in Nairobi. Millicent Omanga was just exposed when she was trying to lie that actually she had sorted out the lady with stock and some cash. That also later turned out to be a lie. So this tweet of today, if you go through various social media platforms about this, actually Kenyans were asking, is this the kind, or rather, are this the kind of evidence this senior counsel always presents to court? Is he not doing his homework before he presents something before the public? This is a video that most likely has been trending for so many months. I just don't know how Ahmed Nasir had not come across this video to a point he can allege that it was taken yesterday. So this video, in a nutshell, just exposes another Tanga Tanga lie. Tanga Tanga leaders, in fact, for the better part since 2018, they have been going away with lies simply because Kenyans were not really very much interested in politics at that time. But now, remaining just some few months to the next general election, I strongly believe that Kenyans now are starting to get interested in what is going on the political stage. So they are trying to exactly see what top politicians and top contenders are actually doing. And they're also going to see what their allies are also doing. So Ahmed Nasir, senior counsel, being a very close William Ruto ally, he has shot himself on the foot here. And I know with this video alone, he has really injured William Ruto's reputation, and he has also injured William Ruto's presidential quest next year. Because now, this just exposes Tanga Tanga as people who have built their political brand on lies and on propaganda. I don't know what you think, ladies and gentlemen, but from where I see it, this is a flat lie that has actually backfired. Secondly, I saw William Ruto today, he was in Taita Taveta. And I saw him dishing out again some saloon machines and some new stuff there. That incident, we are going to analyze it in our next video. But let me just say this. I tend to believe, ladies and gentlemen, that maybe William Ruto might be hearing some of the things you've been saying in this YouTube channel. I've always maintained that William Ruto has to change the narrative. This thing of the wheelbarrows, watu wamekaa kwa kona wanapanga kuchagua viongozi, I think that those are tired narratives. So it's high time William Ruto changes his narrative. He should now come out of this wheelbarrow thing to something different. And I saw him in Taita Taveta today dishing out some things that were not actually wheelbarrows. So for today, ladies and gentlemen, I don't have much to say. So before I conclude, let me remind you that if you've just bumped on this YouTube channel for the very, very first time, subscribe, give this video a like. Give it a like. And to those who are watching us outside of Kenya, for the very, very, very first time, subscribe, give this video a like. Give it a like, please. Give it a like. And also, drop a comment so that we can also know from which part of the globe you are also watching us from. Drop a comment. And then to our esteemed fans and subscribers in this YouTube channel, yes, I'm very, very much humbled and very, very grateful with the kind of progress we are making in this YouTube channel. And this progress, ladies and gentlemen, is largely because of the support you are giving me in this YouTube channel on a daily basis by constantly giving these videos likes and also by constantly dropping your comments on a daily basis. Those are the only parameters, ladies and gentlemen, that YouTube uses to recommend some of these our videos to a wider audience. I'm very, very much grateful. God bless you. God bless Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana.